Hi, my name is Romojit and welcome to our second video on SCCM lab preparedness. Little bit on my background, I am having 8 years of experience in IT field supporting Intel, VMware, SCCM and cloud. This video probably will be the best viewed if you are coming from watching the last video we did, how to install and configure Active Directory for SCCM current branch. If you already have an environment, this might not be as usual for you because we will be jumping around on quite a few configuration before SCCM installation. Based on the flow, in this video I will show you how you can plan and design your Active Directory OU structure for your SCCM site. We will learn step by step what type of users, service accounts and groups we require for a lab setup. You can take this as an example for your production environment as well. So first, we need to look at the Active Directory OU structure. Active Directory OU is a subdivision under your domain where you can place your organization's users, computers and other organization units. We can tune security, access type and group policy for specific or in a group of users or computers using organization unit. To create an OU under your Active Directory domain, open Server Manager Dashboard Console, Tools, Active Directory Users and Computers. As this is a new setup, hence I need to create my OU structure to place my lab systems and other objects. To create an OU, click on the domain name. In my case, it is hyns.in. Right click on it, then click on New, then click on Organizational Unit. Type the OU name, in our case Lab SCCM, and then click on OK to complete. So allow me some time to complete the structure. Alright, we have created the structure. Now, under our Lab SCCM OU, we have created 4 sub OU: Desktop, Servers, Users and Groups. Also, we have created 2 more sub OU for Desktop based on operating system Windows 10 and 11. 3 sub OUs for Servers 2K12, 2K19 and 2K22. Also, we have created 2 more sub OUs based on Servers applications, SCCM and SQL under 2K19. We created different managed users for easily recognize and manage those. Apart from this, we have designed our service account OU structure based on application. Prior to this, we created different OU group structure so we can place the right user to group for the exact security permission provisioning. A clean structure can help you to automate the new user onboarding jobs and other Active Directory automation by integrating tools like ServiceNow or Ansible. We need one user account for our SCCM management, one for SQL Server administration, 3 different domain users, test user 1, 2 and 3 for role-based access, and last, one user account to join the computers in our domain for OSD purpose. To create an AD user, right click on OU, New, then User. First, we'll create a user account which has access to join the computers in domain named adjoin1. Fill the details and then click on Next. Type the passwords and confirm it again. Uncheck the first option and check password never expired. It is recommended to rotate the account password frequently for security hacks. then click on next and finish. Allow me some time to create all the users. Alright, we have created the users and placed adjoin1 under adou, ssm1 under ssm, db1 under msql and test user 1, 2 and 3 to lab users. To manage our SSM infrastructure, we need to create some service accounts for operation perspective. Also, it is required for scheduled jobs to start the service like SSM backup, SQL jobs, client post installation and so on. To create a service account, we can follow the same steps as we performed during AD user creation. Things to note for a service account. Service account will be a standard domain user. Password never expired option should be ticked. Do not rotate the password frequently, else the application associated with the service account will be break and you need to configure the password again for the particular application. Do not share service account's details to anyone. Keep it with your organization's security team. I have created two SQL service accounts, sa-ssm_sql. This service account is used for SSM SQL Server automation jobs and sa-sql_rpt service account for SQL Server reporting services. Also, we required two service accounts for SSM as well. sa-ssm_push for SSM client push installation and sa-ssm_naa SSM network access account. This account is required if you join any workgroup system to our SSM network, then this account will be grant the permission to download the files from SSMDP. Now, to implement role-based administration and grant site permissions in SSM, we will require some groups. Without grouping users or computers, it will be very hectic to manage the user security permission in a large network. Also, it will be easy to apply firewall policies through AD group policy to a set of similar computers for application communication. To create a group, right click on OU, next, then group, enter group name and click on OK. Allow me some time to complete all the group creation. Alright, we have created the required groups for this lab setup. We have created grp-ssm_accounts, grp-ssm_servers and grp-ssm_fullAdmins groups for SSM and place them under group sub OU SSM. Then we have created grp-sql_fullAdmin and grp-sql_accounts group for SQL and place them under MSSQL sub OU. Now let me nested the permission of grp-ssm_accounts to grp-ssm_fullAdmin groups. So our SSM account will have the same permission to connect SQL Management Studio. Alright, that should cover, I think, what I want to cover on this. We will do future video on how we can implement group policy and what are the ports we required for our SQL Server and SSM installation. Please feel free to comment and share your questions. If you like the video, please subscribe. थैंक यू।